在乌克兰和罗马尼亚交界的三角地带，生长着世界最大的芦苇丛。1999年，联合国把乌克兰多瑙河三角洲确定为生物多样性保护区。然而，2004年，乌克兰政府在未公开的情况下，在三角洲启动了多瑙河至黑海运河的第一期工程，打算开展海上运输，而这将对三角洲的生态造成极大破坏。年仅20岁出头且毫无出庭经验的律师奥利亚挺身而出，自愿受理这起对乌克兰政府的诉讼案。
The government of Ukraine decided to build the canal for economic reason. Our organization took the case not because we were against the development. We want to pursue the sustainable development.
到2005年，奥利亚出庭达30多次，他坚持不懈的斗争令官方律师大为吃惊。2年来，奥利亚挑战了政府的律师和部长们，他们对奥利亚和他的委托人进行了恐吓，并公开称他是乌克兰的叛徒和罗马尼亚的间谍。
I was aware that the Ministry of Transport, the former president of Ukraine, were involved in this canal construction, and they were pressing the governmental officials to take positive decision, and judges were told to allow the canal construction.
奥利亚在法庭上遭遇了挫折。无奈之下，他先后2次向国际环境会议提交了诉讼信，请求他们迫使乌克兰政府做出解释。
The first significant victory took place when the court declared illegal the environmental impact statement. The judge was a very brave one. He really went through all of the environmental legislation of Ukraine, even citing the international convention.
奥利亚的努力结果使首期运河的挖掘工程被迫终止了。在上诉过程中，乌克兰橙色革命运动促进了政府的改革。2004年，当尤申科上台时，乌克兰人相信改革真的会到来。
Ми створимо демократичну владу, чесну.
The fight is not over yet. President Yushchenko still wants to continue the canal construction for the economic interests of Ukraine, and that's why we are hoping that the new government will help in our.
接下来，请观赏《武警共九特约之锵锵三人行》。